Hello, storytellers. Welcome to the latest episode of How Stories Fuel Performance. Today, we're going to talk about stories fueling sales, and I'm going to tell you how Cotton Candy used stories to win a huge piece of business. Now, Cotton Candy is a Canadian-based global distributor of branded corporate merchandise. They're a fantastic company. You should check them out if you don't know them. Earlier this year, they were asked to bid on a big piece of global business for a large multinational bank. Their competitors were all bigger and more global in scope than them. They knew it was going to be a tough bid. I had spoken at two employee events for Cotton Candy on leadership and storytelling, and they asked me to come and help them on their bid. When I arrived, not surprisingly, there was a big deck of slides, most of which were full of data and information, and a lot of word slides. And my suggestion was they were not going to beat a bigger, more global competitor with data alone. That was going to be their competitor strength. Rather, they had to be more personal. So we agreed together that they'd open with a story, and then every time one of the members of the pitch team started their segment of the pitch, they'd start with a very short personal story that gave the prospective client some insight into who they were as a person and what they stood for. And I'll let Jen McAvoy from Cotton Candy tell you how it went.
Hi, I'm Jen McAvoy, Director of Client Engagement at Cotton Candy. We're a distributor of corporate branded merchandise. And last year, we were shortlisted to pitch a very large North American bank. We knew that winning it would require beating out some pretty stiff competition and some very slick presentations. We knew Doug because he had been a keynote speaker at some of our sales meetings, and so we reached out to Doug and asked him to help us weave stories into our pitch. We started our presentation with a short personal story about what it took to compete on the world stage, and that segued perfectly into our overall presentation theme. As each of the team members stood up to speak, they all started with a short but relevant personal story. And all of these stories served to make our company stand out and look very unique. Long story short, we won the business, and stories were a big reason why. We knew that our capabilities were solid, but it was the stories that made all the difference because they allowed the client to get a glimpse of the character of the people that would be working on their business. Stories definitely made the difference in winning this business. Stories rule.
The client actually told Cotton Candy that their stories made the difference in the pitch. That's the power of stories in sales. So what can you take away from this? Well, here's three simple things. Number one, a deck of slides never won a piece of business, ever. And yet most companies still start by building a deck and then figuring out how they're going to say what they want to say. Get rid of those data and information-filled slides. Leave them behind for the prospect. Use powerful images and tell short stories. Number two, people don't buy from companies. They buy from other people. They don't want to just know what you've done before. They want to know who you are, what you stand for, and what you'll do for them. And stories are the best way to tell that. And number three, it's not enough to just start with a great story and then beat them over the head with PowerPoint for the next hour or so. Spread little stories throughout your pitch. Make stories your style. Stories rule.